Well, Elizabeth Warren saying that she's not running for president. This amid reports that Joe Biden is preparing for a 2020 run. So where do the Democrats go from here? To campusreform.org editor-in-chief Lawrnce Jones and Democratic strategist Richard Fowler. All right, Richard, Democrats, is it going to be Joe Biden or is there going to be someone new in the mix?
Well, I'm a big Joe Biden fan, but I think it's way too early to figure out who's going to be the head for the front runner in this campaign. I think we've got to get through the midterm elections. And that's where a lot of Democrats are focused right now. We're focused on taking back the House, hopefully taking back the United States Senate and picking up a lot of governors' mansions and state legislatures. So I think that's where our focus is now. And then after that, we'll start focusing on 2020.
Well, you know, Lawrnce, it seems like both parties focus on nonstop and don't stop. It seems the Democrats are in a bind because you've got the new guard, the Kamala Harris, who wants to pick up the Bernie Sanders mantle or the Elizabeth Warren's mantle, and then you have the more establishment types. So either way, it feels like the party's going to be pulled further to the left.
Yeah, that seems to be a common theme with the Democratic Party, and it seems to be growing because the progressive wing of the party is pushing more reasonable candidates to the left. I mean, when you have people going after Senator Feinstein and saying that she's not liberal enough, I think for most conservatives, we would think that she's pretty liberal. But that's where the party is going. I do believe, though, that Joe Biden has the potential of bringing the party back to its roots, where it was concerned about more of the American people and their wages and bringing jobs back to the country, whereas now the Democratic Party seems to be richer, focused on identity politics and things that don't affect the American people on the daily basis.
I don't know if that's true. But, I mean, just look at the two races that we recently won, right? Look at the governor's race in Virginia and look at the Senate race in Alabama. In both of those cases, we ran candidates that fit the state and understood the politics of that state. And they weren't left or right. They were just the right candidates for those states. And that's why they both won their races. So
but,
I think it's less
about... But in a presidential election, though, Richard, you got to pick one candidate. And there's no doubt.
I agree.
There's a push-pull right. going on in your party right now.
No, I mean, I disagree with that. I think what our party is talking about are kitchen table issues. And so if we decide to run a candidate like Joe Biden, Joe Biden's going to have a conversation about how we make ends meet for working families, yeah. right? If we're going to
well,
have
what about we're talking taxes, about- Richard? Because no Democrat voted for the tax proposal. You even have your leader, Nancy Pelosi, calling it crumbs. And so I think when you have average day Americans that are living paycheck to paycheck, I mean, tax reform is something that is big for them. And I don't understand how your party is going to be able to communicate that to the American people.
I'll answer that. I think the reason why Democrats voted against this tax cut bill is because it didn't go far enough. It left all the loopholes that were in the previous tax code open. What Democrats are saying, we're willing to cut taxes. Barack Obama had the biggest middle-class tax cut in American history. We're willing to have a conversation about cutting taxes. We're willing to lower the corporate tax rate. But in exchange for that, we've got to close some of the loopholes that continue to exist that allow hedge fund managers to walk away with billions of dollars. Let me jump in.
Richard, I hear what you're saying, but not only did no Democrats vote for, but Nancy Pelosi's been dissing it every single day, calling
right.
it crumbs.
By the way,
you got a guy running tomorrow who's got a good chance of winning. He's distancing himself from Nancy Pelosi.
Listen, I'm not going to defend everything Nancy Pelosi says either, but I think there's a larger conversation here. To say that Democrats are against tax cuts is just wrong. We were against the tax reform.
Gentlemen, we got to leave it there.
Because it was a bad bill.
Guys, we got to leave it there. Not a bad bill for a whole lot of millions of Americans. Not
yeah,
so
it wasn't
far.
A bad. It also wasn't
All
a bad
right,
bill for Wall Street hedge fund managers.